energyPRO is really about designing an energy system. It originally began its life as CHP design, and as the name suggests, was all about CHP, but subsequently has developed into being able to model any energy system from a country to an individual building. So it's a very flexible product, and you can model pretty much anything. So this is energyPRO, and this is a project that I've already built. You can see on this graphical interface, we've added a couple of boilers of just under a megawatt each with a fuel, which is natural gas. We've got a heat demand, an electricity demand, which is supplied by an electricity market in London. And actually, over here, we can see lots more inputs, prices, incentives, taxes, and indeed some capital investments here. While this particular project is set up with UK specific taxes and incentives, you can model pretty much any financial arrangement that you might need in any country in the world. If you look here, you can see we can add lots of different types of energy conversion unit, from boilers, as we've got here, to CHP, types of chiller, renewable systems such as heat pumps, solar thermal, photovoltaics, wind farm, and also we've got types of rejection, so heat rejection, cooling rejection, and so on. And here we've got storage. You can see thermal stores, cold stores, batteries, and even hydro pumping, and electric vehicles operating in vehicle-to-grid mode. And then we can model heating and cooling and electricity demands and electricity markets, either spot markets or fixed tariff markets. So there's plenty of flexibility there to add different systems. And there are more options. You can, in fact, add process heat demands as well, so such as steam. And you can even create fuels and have units that use fuels so that you can model electrolysis and hydrogen. So pretty much anything is possible in energyPRO. You can see also that we have CO2 emission factors here, which are specific UK ones, but you can set up your own emission factors for gas and electricity and whatever fuels you might have in your project. So that's totally customizable. Okay, so let's have a look at an actual simulation. This is an hourly simulation, and we're viewing a single week. It can actually be anything down to a resolution of 1 minute. But you can see our heat demand, and you can see that boiler one is supplying the heat demand most of the time. If you look at the bottom graph, you can see our electricity demand is varying. This week we're looking at is in May, but you can zoom around and look at any point in the year, and you can also see the whole year in one go. At the top, you can see we've got a net production cost graphic. Now, that is essentially calculating in every time step the cost of dispatching that particular unit. In this case, we only have the boilers, so it's a rather simple optimization. This is a compare project, by which I mean it relies on the compare module in energyPRO. In fact, we've got multiple tabs down here along the bottom, so you can see updated projects with variants of this initial reference tab. So we can see we've added a CHP unit, which is a 505 kilowatt electric. Here you can see we've added a CHP and a thermal store. Here you can see we've added an air source heat pump instead of the CHP with a thermal store. And here you can see we've added solar PV together with the air source heat pump and the store. And finally, we've added a battery alongside the solar PV and the air source heat pump and the store. So what this enables me to do is to take any building or scheme of whatever energy system that you're modeling, the district heating scheme. In this case, it's a very large leisure centre. And then it enables the user to compare different scenarios of technologies or prices or whatever variable it is you want to change. And you can then make changes in each of these tabs and run comparison reports. So if I scroll down here, you can see I can choose from these compare reports and I can run the compare cash flow report. So you can see the revenues at the top of the income, sale, export in the case of CHP and the PV, and subsidies. And then there are costs, the gas costs and electricity costs in all their complexity with taxes and charges on electricity. And then we can see the bottom line, the net cash flow. And you can see it changing from our original case of costing us £864,000 to run this leisure centre in terms of gas and electricity. And then you can see how that changes with those different technologies applied. The CHP actually with the thermal store is giving us the best picture, but the air source heat pump and the PV and the battery scenario are also improving things over our reference case. So we've got investments here. So let's now look at some more financial results. So if we go to tools, we can bring this up, which is actually a spreadsheet embedded inside energyPRO. And we can set a period to look at. So we can say, let's look over 10 years. We can set a discount rate, 3.5%, which might be a typical public sector discount rate. And then we can see for our options. So we can see the investments that we're making. So going up to anything up to 1.8 million here in the case of the most complex one. And then we can see the changes in operational income. So in each case, we're saving a few £100,000 a year, obviously varies between the options. And then we can see our net present value based on that discount rate. So actually the best one is the CHP with the thermal store. We can see the simple payback time. So anything between 2.5 and 8 years over here. And then our internal rates of return and how those vary. So obviously I could go back and I could change the planning periods, look at a longer time, change the net present value and the internal rate of return. I could also change the discount rate and see different NPVs as a result. Thank you very much for listening.